Better. Better. Ayanapa. Better jaga down. We go Ayanapa. Me go Ayanapa. Me go Ayanapa. Me go Ayanapa. La Naka. La Naka. That's what it's called, isn't it? The airport. I don't care what you say. This is my I put the flight face. Soaking what bush, Naya? Have you heard that new song? I put it as a talking topic. Do you know that guy who used to go on the streets of Caribbean and be like, oh, how do you spell heaven or whatever? Yeah, yeah. Daniel Loveless?
That's his name, okay.
He released a song. This is the definition of Trinidad noise. It's called Vetting Commissioner or something. It's the next break we have. I'm going to play it to you.
Yeah, I have.
Noise.
No, I have actually.
It's the kind of music that if I was in Trinidad, if I was on the road, it might be acceptable. But anywhere else, it just sounds rubbish. I don't even know what's going on. I'm the vetting commissioner. It's like a mashup.
Well, we're coming down now.
It's the 19th tomorrow, isn't it? Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back, guys. You are tuned into Bacchanal Radio, the home of Caribbean vibes. And this right here is the Bim Bam Show. Have you not got a sound effect?
Of course.
Can we have a sound effect? Oh, ow. Yes, it is the Bim Bam Show here. Sunday, the 19th of November. We are back. We are badder than ever. And we are ready for the dibbiness.
Of course. We love dibbiness.
Yes, you know, Bim Bam Show is nothing but dibbiness. Bacchanal, vibes, tunes. I don't know what else we got here. What else we got?
What?
No, she's right. The theme of this episode is water.
Mm-hmm.
Last time we had rum, now we have water. And if I look at my notes for the show, Marsha put in brackets, everything wet.
Yes, man. Well, what else is water doing?
So, technically, the theme of the show is water and everything wet.
Yeah.
Jesus. So, you can imagine the kind of topics we have today in the show.
You're talking about water now. I haven't got a clue.
Okay, you talk about water. I'll talk about everything wet. So, at the top of the show, we had Nyla Blackman, Something in the Water. The theme is water and everything wet. Let's go. What is... Why would he call himself Flea?
I know.
That's like when I used to work in Ladbrokes ages ago, I had a Jamaican guy. His name was Roach. Roachy. Now, his surname might have been Roach, but he was incredibly ugly, and he said that. I said, why is your name Roach? He said, come ugly. I couldn't even tell him he was lying. I was like, okay. Okay, I forgot all about the Barbados Dinner and Dance Gala, and now it's flipping sold out. It wasn't on Eventbrite when I saw the flyer, and then I just subsequently forgot all about it. And then I saw it sold out.
I remember you saying you wanted to go. Like,
yeah, I text Tyrone, he's the head of the BCR. I was like, can I have a ticket anyway?
So we'll see. Yeah.
He might give me a bye. Oh yeah, that's what I was doing, showing you the song.
Oh God, yeah.
Oh, Never mind, it's not bad. It's just
not inspiring at all. It's not giving anything.
That's what I'm trying to say. It's not bad, but it's just not giving anything. And he tried to put in his slogan. Okay, his slogan is now you know, or something like that. During his show, he goes, well, now you know, or something like that. And he put in there, if you don't know, now you know. Bro, I don't know if you think you're Puff Daddy. Just stop with the nonsense.
Yeah, but Puff Daddy, but man, Puff Daddy got problems. He got problems.
Oh, God. No. I only date guys who lift me, trying to impress her. I lift his name on high. It's so stupid. Lovely water. So stupid. These lyrics are ridiculous. Lovely water. When have you ever called water lovely?
Nah.
Water. This song is nonsense. Water. All right, Masha. Masha. Water. Even this I've got. It's for when you got to like press play on your phone without touching it. Like, say you're doing like a TikTok and you wanna can do it from this. Bacchanal Radio. Oh, boy. I haven't even heard that one before. Marsh, where you find that?
Oh, look at Vinci Soca, look at Vinci Soca.
So that was Water by Flea. Can you imagine?
Yeah, the name. And I don't know why. Why would you name yourself Flea?
Like I said, people in the Caribbean don't care, you know. They name you after what you look like or whatever. No, it's true. So he must look like one. No, I bet he's Marga. And have some tin legs. I bet. How much do you want to bet if we look up Flea, he's slim, like a flea?
Sorry, guys.
Or maybe he's just bothersome, like a flea. But, you know, we like to name you what you are. We're not messing. So I can imagine him already. Flea, maybe you are stunning and... But you can be stunning a Marga, so... I'm going to look him up. Flea, we'll soon see you.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Marsha?
Yes, Milera.
We're back?
We are back on Bacchanal Radio.
Back on Bacchanal Radio with a diviness. It's your girl, Ruth Amore.
And I am Marsha, of course.
You and we are. Bam, we are Bim and Bam.
Bim and Bam, or just Bim Bam.
Or just Bim Bam.
Yeah.
And Bim Bam is about to get down with some relationship dilemmas, trivias, situationships, help me ships, SOS, that kind of thing. What you got for me this week, Marsh?
So, talking to a few people this week, you know, just little things wondering about, you know, relationships we thought. And basically, it was like, can you be friends with your ex?
Can you?
Yeah.
For me, it's not a can you, it's a... Why? I don't know why you don't. Of course you can, but I just feel like, why? Why? Unless, for example, you've decided like a real dibby person to go out with somebody in your workplace, and so therefore you have to be cordial and, you know, be a friend in that sense. Otherwise, I can't see the purpose of staying friends with an ex. That's my problem. I can't see the purpose. Unless you dated your friend, again, why did you do that? Why on earth would you want to be friends with your ex? Why? Who is it serving?
Well,
I'm just like, wow.
I know, like, okay, aggression. Oh, no, yeah? That's just like, not for you.
Because you can. I just don't know why is my point. Of course you can. If you're an adult that can put your feelings aside and you can be mature, great. Good on you. You're going to heaven. But if you're like me and you can't bother, I can't bother. Because I know me. To be honest, first of all, there's no person, there's no ex that's in my life. Like, I don't work with them, I don't live near them. So there's no person I've had to be friendly with.
Mm-hmm.
And I like to think I'm the bigger person. But to be honest, now, if I'm going to be honest, I probably couldn't, because I could be nice and I can be adult like whatever, but like, say we for some reason go into an argument, I'd be like, yeah, and that's why we're not together.
Just bring it right back.
Just bring it back. Some unfinished business. So I can, in that I don't, in that I wouldn't want you, so I could be friends with you, but I just know if we got into an argument or something, I'm just
you're
being
petty. Right back in their face.
That's petty.
Why I left you. Okay. Oh dear. Well, we did a bit of research.
Okay.
And what I found out, they said you've forgiven each other for anything that was hurtful. That's the first start. So you can be friends with an ex if you've forgiven them for anything that could potentially have hurted you.
Okay.
Second way you can be friends, the idea of them dating another person doesn't give you the ick. It doesn't make you feel, oh, you know, you're okay. You hit on a new relationship, you're like, oh, doesn't faze you. You're fine.
Okay.
Third reason, you're not going to play mind games like...
Yeah, I'm out.
Like you just said, basically.
I'm out.
As soon as they've upset you or you disagree, you say, well, that's why X, Y, and Z.
Or the opposite, like, if you were like a work person and I've got a thing that's late, I'll be like, oh, come on. You know, just have a word with the boss for me. Like, both ways, like, I'll just be wildly inappropriate because I'm going to use it to my advantage every time. Win arguments, get projects. Yeah, mind games.
And lastly, you can be friends if enough time has passed and you both feel at peace.
Here's the thing, yeah. We're saying it's okay to be friends with your ex and we're assuming you're both single. But what if that person gets a girlfriend? And okay, you might not be jealous, but they might not want you friends with them. Do you know what I mean? Why would you? I wouldn't want my partner to be in a friendship with their ex. That's not, do you know what I mean? Mm. So even if you can be friends with your ex, if they've moved on or they have a partner, I think it might be slightly inappropriate to even have a friendship with your ex, because what are you doing? What are you doing? Don't you have nothing better to do? You have no, you have no other friends, no other person you can talk to than the person you're bumping uglies with. You can't find a single person to talk to. For me, it just sounds desperate. I just find it completely unnecessary.
I hear what you're saying. I mean, for me, the likelihood of me being friends with my ex, I would like to say I am friends with some of my exes, but friends in what capacity? I say happy Christmas.
Yeah, that's
happy
different.
Happy birthday once a year, and if I see you at a place, I'm happy to talk to you, we laugh and joke and whatever.
Yeah, that's being cordial, that's not being friends.
But there are people that I've been out with. One guy particularly comes to mind that I think we should have been friends from the off. We kind of knew.
Okay, so you made a mistake. You messed up then.
Well, we didn't mess up. Like, we just kind of realised pretty soon that you need to just remain friends.
Mm.
Friends. We're good as friends.
But maybe that's a bit different, because that feels like the relationship shouldn't have happened in the first place. And you were, do you know what I mean? So
Yeah. Like, oh, you know, maybe we should have gone down this road, because I don't really like you like that. But I like the friend. Yeah, me too. Yeah, okay.
Glad. Yeah, that's a bit different. But I would still say over a certain amount of time, probably, I'm going to say it's not going to be inappropriate, because if you're truly friends, it can't be inappropriate. But when you start getting partners and moving on, I think you'll naturally just drift away again, maybe.
Well, that's what's happened, obviously.
You'll just start.
He got married, had his kids, I got married, had my
kids. Because there's only so much you can do once that person moves on before it is a bit...
You know, and then you just lose touch because you get on with your own lives. It's not like we fell out, just life got in the way, just living.
You're sliving.
Yeah, so that was interesting.
I want to know the ex now.
Oh, a nice man. Yeah, all right.
Nice gentleman.
Yeah, nice gentleman.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Big up the nice gentleman, ex. Ex. Okay. I got a question for you, Marsh. Or actually, I'm presenting to you an odd situation, and I want to hear if it's just odd for me, it feels dodgy. Well, not dodgy, strange. Okay, so I was scrolling on a very reputable site, just full of facts, fact checks by doctors and lawyers, and, you know, I think it's probably even checked by the Standard. Who knows?
Wow.
Anyway, the place is called TikTok.
Reliable source of information.
Yeah, very reliable, very fact worthy. And I I found a little tickety-tockety reel, whatever you want to call it. And it was of probably one of the UK's most eligible bachelors, like career, looks, you know, most people would say it's a catch. It's a big deal.
And who is this big deal?
Anthony Joshua.
Ooh.
Ooh. See, your eyes brightened up.
Her whole face lights up like a light bulb.
You see? Okay, so he was given an interview and he had an answer about his relationship status, which is single, by the way, which actually does play a key role in what I'm about to show you guys. Okay. So he is single, but he had this to say. Marsha, you going to share?
Okay, let me share. That's the living moment. Why am I going to move out home by herself for some girl? When a woman marries a man, the man divorces his mom. Hell no. When a man marries, she becomes a child of the mom. Quite traditional. When a girl gets with me, she ain't just marrying me, she's marrying my family.
Well, well, well. So Anthony Joshua is currently single, but his take on things is that he is not leaving his mum. He doesn't mean metaphorically. I think he means literally, as in physically. He still wants to share a residence with his mum. So at first, I thought it was just that while he's single, he might as well. And that makes sense. Why leave your mum in a house by herself? Mm-hmm. But he means, like, even if he gets married, this girl's moving in. Like, this is what's happening. So, you know, it could be called a mama's boy to most people. That would be the case. So what are your thoughts? Like, not just on Anthony Joshua, because I'm not singling him out just in case I ever see this dude in my lifetime. I don't want him to take them two punching fists and knock me down on the floor. So hypothetically speaking, is dating a mummy's boy or a mama's boy like a no-go, or is it just something to work around?
See, so, I don't think that's mummy's boy. So you got okay. So for me personally, okay, remember in the Caribbean, we have extended families.
Yeah.
So what he sounds like to me, he's talking about is that extended family unit.
Okay.
His girlfriend becoming his wife is coming into his family. Now, obviously, living in the UK, you know, that whole extended family dynamic has practically disappeared. So we don't do it in the UK. Your mum place, you live one place, your sister lives somewhere else. That whole big family living in under one roof with different generations doesn't really exist much in the UK. But from the Caribbean point of view, that's normal. So I'm actually okay with it.
Okay. I mean, here's the thing. I think he's in a specific kind of genre. He's already super successful. So the amount of like negatives someone like Anthony Joshua can have on his name is always going to be outweighed by the fact that he's hugely successful. He's cares about his community. So he has so much on the plus side that for me, for a man like Anthony Joshua, it's a minor. Living with his mum is a minor. Having him be quote unquote a mama's boy is a minor. I'm talking about real life people now. Let's take him way out of the equation because you can't work with that kind of maths whatsoever. For normal people now, I think if you're a mama's boy, it can be an issue because it's not just about him overdoting and overloving on his mom because that is not the issue. It's just that sometimes if the mother is also quite attached to the son, it can be a blocker. Do you know what I mean? Because you know, they say that a man can't serve two masters or whatever the case is. And sometimes that becomes a blocker because say you have an opinion that's completely opposite to the mum and the mum's like, well, I want it left and you saying you want it right. He's always going to be this referee person because, you know what I mean? He's always banging the middle. So I think in general, someone who is a mama's boy, it can cause issues because you can hardly be putting your wife first when your mum is first. It just, you can't have two firsts. That's not how it works. And so I think it could be an issue for a normal person.
If it's not managed correctly, yeah, definitely be an issue.
It can be
an
issue.
Yeah, it can be an issue. It could be an issue if it's not managed correctly. However, I do like the whole idea of the whole extended family, having grandma there, the grandkids. I like all that. So if it's that kind of healthy environment, I'm all for it. But if it's the case that him just can't left him mother, she and can't leave him. Yeah. She still has to wash your underpants and all
imagine,
them things
like,
there.
Because imagine things like holidays. What if, like I said,
if you've got a nice mother-in-law, all this goes out the window. But you've got to just sometimes think of the worst case scenarios, because marriage is not always happy, happy. There's some down bits. And then now you're having a down bit with the man and the woman. So what? You're going to go on, you can't go on a holiday by yourself because you've got to bring the mum. Or you can't go out to dinners because you've got to bring the mum. Or if you're making any kind of life decision, the mum's got to okay it because she's kind of the head of the household. Do you know what I'm trying to, you count how many heads of the household you have in. So she has to okay it. Where your kids go to school, the manners, like every 2 minutes she's telling you, oh, this child, I want it done. Like, do you know, it can just be like an overbearing thing.
Yeah, it can. Because joke aside,
you need to be a queen of your house too. But you, what, a king and two queens? How is that running? How is that running?
It's not going to run. Yeah. When it's toxic, it's not going to work.
Marriage is already hard. It's already hard. And then it means you are also serving two masters, your husband and his mum.
Mm-hmm.
If the two of them ain't happy, you ain't happy. And if anything, they're looking at you. You're the alien. You're the imposter. You leave. You can't even
The alien, you know.
You can't even throw your husband on the sofa because
his mum won't let you.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. So when you're vexed with him, right, you and you're telling about his whole self, you can't even say nothing. That's her son.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No. And you're vexed and you're like, you know, I'm not cooking you dinner. The mum's going to cook it. So he's not losing. He has no fear of what you can possibly turn around and do because he knows you can't throw him out on the sofa. He knows if you don't cook, the mum's going to do it. Like, really and truly, you just have zero power.
Yeah, unless you get a good mother-in-law and she's on your side.
But if you have a good mother-in-law, it don't matter. Mama's will, not mama's boy. Having a good mother-in-law is peak. Is peak made it sort of situation. So I think it could be a problem. But you know me. Who did I ask?
Okay, Uncle Google.
I did ask, but I tried to be very diplomatic. And I asked Google how to have a successful relationship with a mama's boy. Because if we go back to Anthony Joshua again, we think that's a good deal. So it's not about if, it's about how we're going to do this.
Yeah.
How are we going to do this, Tony? How are we going to do this?
Talk to me.
So here's the 10 tips. I'll start at 10. So don't let her have anything to do with your finances. That is actually very important.
Yeah, yep.
Because it's supposed to be, if not 50-50, some kind of breakdown. If she has control of the finances, she has control full stop. Where you're sleeping, everything. 9, don't include her in your problems because she will only take his side anyways. Mm-hmm. Don't share too much with your mother-in-law. Make decisions together without asking her. So taking her out of the equation. Encourage him to take care of himself alone. That means wash your own underpants,
all them kind
of things. Remind him of what it means to be an adult. That one is harsh. 4, don't live with his mother. See? So this is, 3, encourage him to establish clear boundaries. 2, you establish your clear boundaries. And 1, and this is a good one, don't make him choose, in brackets, because he will always choose his mum. Yes. Yes.
Emotional damage.
Correct. So being a mama's boy isn't a bad thing, or being married to a mother's boy isn't a bad thing. A man who is close to his mother is not a mama's boy in a negative way. In fact, research shows that boys and men who have strong relationships with their mothers are mentally healthier, more empathetic, and have better relationships with women in general.
Aww, I like that last summary.
Yes, so that means Anthony Joshua, you're still on the cards.
You're still a catch.
You're still a catch.
Hey. Niceness. Okay. Yes, Mr. Joshua, we liking that.
We are liking that. I mean, there wasn't much that was going to sway us to be...
No. No. Anything him says, all right.
Yes, sir.
Anything you want. Want some water?
Behave, Marsha.
Yeah, anyway, niceness.
Take a bath. Jump in the water. Take a bath. Jump in the water. Take a bath.
Yes, you are back. It is back on our radio. It is the Bim Bam Show, and the title or the theme of this show is water, brackets, everything that is wet. We just played Indiwater, but I can never pronounce this. Indiwater by Sharar?
I don't know. Is it Shura? You know, Shura? Anyway, whatever that is, and Shuwara, child minister.
Yes. Before that, we had Take a Bathe by Iowa George. There was no way we could have a theme of water and not have Iowa George. We could even possibly just have Iowa George for every song and probably it would still work.
You know the amount of water songs this man has.
I know. A lot of verse. Yes, theme is water. It is the Bim Bam Show. It's your girl, Ruth Amore.
And Marsha Miss Pond the Road.
Yes, and just to tie up, if you've just joined the show, we just had a convo around Mama's Boys. So to all those that are watching or listening on Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, wherever it is, the question is, would you date a Mama's Boy? Brackets, what if it was Anthony Joshua?
Yeah.
Marsh, you got some more dibbiness for me?
I have. I've got a bit of dibbiness. So
A bit?
Yeah, it's a bit of dibbiness. So okay. Something fun, nothing too serious, guys.
Okay.
So it just popped up on my FB feed, just scrolling through the socials as you do, you know?
Yeah.
And it popped up saying, there's a list for men, and it outlines the types of women that men shouldn't date.
Okay.
This is hilarious.
Okay? Go for it.
Right. So first one, South London women.
Agreed. Sorry, was it a yes, no
have
game?
Have you got any friends from South London? Because you've got to fall out with them now.
I'm going to say agree or disagree. Keep going.
Okay. Mixed women.
I wouldn't know. I don't know. I mean, they always say rhythm and a problem, isn't it? But I don't know. This is a bit harsh to put a whole like race of people in there.
Okay, let me continue.
Cheeky.
December Sagittarius.
I don't even know what that means. I don't do star sign business.
Me neither. I was like, okay. Women that drive buses or trains.
I think that's a red card, you know. That's harsh. People who drive buses, what is it? It might be uniform, you know, because the uniform doesn't fly. I've not seen a single woman in like London transport or whatever that looks good in the uniform. The uniform is just not the one. So maybe that's why. Or maybe they're just hardcore. Been through too much stress in life, just hardened and brittle and dry and crispy.
Well, for this particular gentleman, the list he's put together is a no-go.
Okay, I'm on the fence with that one because you might get a free bus pass, free little oyster.
Yeah, look a free nest.
So I'm on the fence. Keep going.
Okay, Jamaican women.
I mean...
emotional damage.
Do you know what? I'm going to no comment that completely.
Yeah, I think we should no comment that one, actually.
Considering my company as well.
Yeah. Next, hairdressers.
No, that is a straight up violation. Hairdressers, they can do your hair. What are you even talking? I mean, unless you're bald. Unless you're bald, then yes, dating a hairdresser doesn't help you in any kind of way. Otherwise, that is a win. That is literally a win.
I thought that would be a benefit, to be totally honest.
Why would that? Oh, is it because there was a man coming to their house? Is that why? Because I heard something about all this man coming and sitting in between their legs and all kind of thing. And someone was saying, oh, they're not letting their girl do hair to be doing that round, man. Maybe it's that. I think.
Well, why are you buying a girl a proper hair chair so she can do it properly?
This is what I mean.
Oh, help her sister
I reckon that's why it is. I've seen posts before about that kind of thing. Like, oh, if you let men go to your girls have to get their hair done, then you're crazy if you think, you know, nothing's happening or some kind of nonsense.
Nonsense!
That's nonsense. I mean, unless that happens and she ain't never got the cash in her hand, that's nonsense. Different. If she goes to do hair and there's no cash, then maybe you want to wonder how he paid. But exactly. Other than that,
if it's her business and a job, maybe she's got a salon. What type of hairdresser are you talking about? And if she's doing hair from home, I would think she's doing male and female. And if you're that concerned, buy her salon things and maybe stop the noise.
Maybe it's the chatting the business. I don't know. I'm not. That's with the bus drivers. I'm actually okay with this one. I think hairdressers will get a green card.
Yeah, I don't know where he's going with
they
that
get
one.
They get a pass. Next.
Grenadian women.
Here's the thing. I know about Grenadian men. I don't know about no Grenadian women. So again, I can't. That one is, I'm sitting on that fence firm. I'm sitting on the fence firm. Okay.
Back to the star signs, February Aquarius.
I don't care when you're born, honestly. Honestly, don't care.
Okay, women who have council jobs.
Again, I think this is close to the the bus drivers where I think they've just been hardened by life, so they're gonna be really like really aggressive and stubborn and just fed up of life. But otherwise, again, the perks. I don't know. There might be perks.
It could be perks.
Okay.
Now this one is well bright. Women whose second toe is longer than the big toe.
They may not even be women at this point. They could be aliens. Who's dating Flipper? Not me. No, it's Flipper. Why is your toe... Anyway, I don't like feet. So I don't even feel comfortable talking about people's toes, honestly. But that would freak me out. That would freak me out. You are never wearing Crocs. You are never wearing, what's it, the Havanias? Them flip-flops. Havanias. You're not open wearing
toe sandals.
No,
peep-toe,
you can't go.
Peep toe.
You can't go anywhere with her. What are you gonna do?
No, that's harsh.
Who's going with her? Not me. Not me. I can't even go on Sandals Beach with you. In sandals, even. No. No, thank you. You keep them abnormal sausage rolls to yourself.
No. September Virgos.
Nobody cares.
Okay. Nurses.
No, we need them. We need them. We were all clapping and saluting our nurses a few months ago.
Exactly.
Now we're not dating them. They had to go through COVID and now they can't get a date. Low the nurses, bruv. Low the nurses.
This one is well weird. Women who wear Nike Air Forces.
Yeah, I'm with him.
I don't actually own a pair, but what is it about Nike Air Forces?
I'm with him. I think it's because it came into trend and then like everybody was wearing them and they were like really dusty. You always see them like mashed down Air Forces on the train of them girls with weird tight... Why are tracksuit bombs tight these days? It's really getting me really confused. Anyway, I'm going off on a tangent. I kind of agree a little bit there just because I know what he's going for, although I don't actually know anyone that owns any Air Forces, but yeah.
And finally, East London women.
I totally agree. Yeah. I don't really like going East London, period. So I actually don't even like East London people. So.
Yes, again, do you have any friends in East London? Because you're going to fall out with them today.
I don't even like people from East London. I don't even like places in East London. I don't even like the Jubilee line. So, I mean, I don't know what to tell you. East London is just not for me. If I see an event and I'm feeling it, as soon as I see the E16, E17, E, count me out. Count me out. I'm not wearing a trilby. I'm not going Carnaby Market. Whatever you people in East London are doing, I'm not doing it.
So any friends of Ruth that live in East London, friendship is terminated.
Friends? Quote, unquote, babes. Need to quote, unquote.
Friends? Associates? People she knew her?
People. Yeah, I'm not for it. Everyone, no, all my friends or people that I know in East London, they know I'm not for them. They know I'm not for them. That if anything happens, haven't got your back.
I haven't got your back. Chat to your back.
Yeah, literally. I haven't got your back. In fact, I'm on their side. So just, I'm so done with East London.
Savage. Savage. God. Thank the Lord I live in West London. Listen,
if you live in East London, you're not for me. Okay? I haven't got your back. We're not friends. I've lied to you. Okay? I'm not coming to see you. I'm not coming anywhere near. I'm not going East London. Okay? I don't like Jubilee Line even. I don't like the Jubilee Line. I don't like... What is that nonsense? DLR. I don't like DLR. I'm not doing it. I don't like Blackwall Tunnel. Let me just say that from now. I've only been to Stratford East once. I'm not into Greenwich. The list goes on. I won't wear a trilby. I don't like Carnaby Market. Okay? I want to make this perfectly clear. You're not the one. I don't even know why there's a place called Canada Water. I'm not happy about it. What else don't I like about East London? The list literally goes on and on. I'm just fed up. I think it's because I used to like that band E17. And that's East London. So I don't want nothing to do with that neither because Brian Harvey is weird, isn't it? So that's also another East London thing I don't want to talk about anymore. Yeah.
Okay, way off on some tangent. She doesn't like East London, guys. It's that simple. Okay, we know. Sorry. Wow, I feel like I shouldn't have even said anything now. All right, what do you want to talk about, Ruth? Let's move on swiftly.
This is a quick one.
Yes, please.
Quick. Think of your most successful relationship.
Hey?
What do you mean, hey? Like, you never had one?
Well, yes. What do you mean? A romantic relationship?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm thinking.
What was that? Wow. Hey, whoever is got her smiling.
Yeah, man.
What was their best quality?
Kind.
Babes, when you said the cur word. What? I didn't know.
No, because you see how you stay. You see how your mind always goes to the left. You see you.
No, not to the left, to the right. To because the right. I looked at you and I thought we had the connection and you went, and I was like, no, but okay.
You thought I was something else. No, you're very kind. I was going to say
aubergine emoji.
Oh, yeah, you have that too, but.
Okay, I think they do have one. That is the kind of yeah,
something
requisite.
Nah, something nah, good.
Some stale aubergine. Overripe aubergine.
All the people named aubergine.
Shared aubergine. Off-price aubergine.
All of that too. No, he's a kind guy. Very nice.
I really thought there was something else in there. I was about to say, Marsha, come on. It's not a kid's show, but...
No. I know. I can't think of other things besides that, but no, he was kind.
Okay. That is literally all I wanted to ask you. Do you want to expand on that?
No. But why are you asking that question?
Just because I think we run down... We don't run down men. But sometimes my opinions of men are less than favourable. So I wanted to lighten up the mood and keep the haters off my back by giving some positive feedback around black and probably black Caribbean men. And now we've done that 30 seconds, we can use the rest of the show.
No, okay. To say whatever we like. Let's not be so harsh on our lovely Caribbean men out there. There are some good eggs out there. There are.
Okay. Can I just say one thing?
Yes.
I do a lot of videos on TikTok that is not as playful joking around about Caribbean men. I get lots of comments, lots of views. I made one or two that said, here's five things we love about Caribbean men.
Okay.
Barely any views, hardly any comments. Honestly, they're not here for it.
No.
People are just not here for
it. Why people do my Caribbean men like that? Don't do them like that.
I was like, there's so many good things about, because I need to balance it, because people are beginning to think I'm some man basher.
And you're far from that.
Right. But the funny thing is, if you are in the Caribbean community, you would know it's jokes.
It's just bantz.
But I guess other people are like, literally, I've had comments saying, what happened to you in this Grenadian man that made you so? And I have to be like, sis, this is social media. This is not real life.
This is hypothetical, though. This is, you know, just like, do hello. Do people think
I literally went to each island, picked up one man and sampled just so I could give you relevant feedback on a TikTok? Is that what they think I've done? Has that never crossed their mind? How can she possibly have known all this about every single man from every island? What do they think I've been doing between the TikTok videos? Just like finding a man from Belize just to confirm. Going to the Bahamas just to confirm. No, it's just jokes. It's just bantz.
Yeah.
So I wanted to use the time to do a little flip side of my usual jokes to be like, oh, and then you said kind. And that we can add that to some of the things that Caribbean men are good at.
Mm-hmm.
Food. The cooking. Oh, yes.
A lot of them
oh,
can
God,
cook.
If you find a Caribbean man that can cook.
You're gone clear.
That's how they end up horning, because you're confused. The bakes got you confused. The oil down got you confused. And at home smiling full belly. And they're gone. They're gone out.
Your belly's full. You're like, okay, babe, bye.
With the same energy that food gave him, he's going to take that energy in his belly to go and so he's like, I'm back on the cussing again. Anyway, food. Food is something.
Yeah.
Waistline. It's good. Accents.
I find Caribbean men born in the Caribbean,
mm-hmm.
not the ones that are second or third generation here in the UK. I find Caribbean men from the Caribbean are very, I'm going to say, handy with their hands. But
to
in a
what?
Good way. In a good way.
Like, how can you be handy in a bad way?
Like carpentry and things. Oh. You know, like, yeah, stuff like that. No, they're good.
You mean a skill?
Yeah, they have skill.
A craft.
With their hands. Hey.
So they can what? They can craft,
they can
and, build.
Craft and build.
What else? Mold.
Mold, yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But the UK ones don't seem to have them skills. But they don't. They don't. They're nonsense.
You're
nonsense.
Going back to the bashing again. What does we doing positive stuff?
Yeah, I'm bashing the UK Caribbean second and third generation ones. No, no, it's not.
Okay, we've said food, we've said waistline, we've said accents, we've said, I can't remember some things we said.
Handy, skillful.
And we said aubergine. I don't know what else. Just good bantz.
Yeah, and they're good looking, isn't it?
Melanin. There's that melanin drip.
They're just good looking, isn't it?
In it.
In it.
Okay, I think we've had enough positivity now. I feel clean in my conscience to say whatever I feel like for the rest of the show, deal?
Okay.
Good.
Fine. Patrice again. Nessa! We go kill him with the wine, girl. Kill him with the wine, girl. That's right. Slash! Body wet up. Wet girl. What the man them prefer. Drip drop on a wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer. Body wet up, wet girl, where the man them prefer. Drip drop on a wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer, baby. Flash.
Will you call that sauce? Kinda wine make man what he wants. Cause them want be single, single. Them man want to mingle, mingle.
Where you are? Loose this. Want to taste some sweet, sweet juice. Hey, I go give you the wine, but you have to work for this ride. Flash.
Body wet up, wet girl, where the man them prefer. Drip drop. Body wet like prefer, baby. Body wet up, wet girl with the man them prefer. Trip drop when I wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer, baby.
Everywhere you see me, I put on me looking dreamy. I bet you see in this steam there, and this waka walk in that tail.
What you like? Looseness? Want a sample the juice? I go give you the wine, but you have to work for this ride.
Flash. Body wet up, wet girl, where the man them prefer. Drip drop on a wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer, baby. Flash. Body wet up, wet girl, where the man them prefer. Drip drop on a wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer, baby. Flash.
What you call that sauce? Kinda wine make man what he wants. Cause them want be single, single. Them man want to mingle, mingle.
Where you are? Loose this. Want to taste some sweet, sweet juice.
Body wet up, wet girl with the man them prefer. Trip drop when I wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer, baby.
Flash. Body wet up, wet girl with the man them prefer. Trip drop when I wine and bubble. Body wet like prefer, baby.
Patrice, and Nessa Peppy. Let me go, P. Hey.
Closer to you on Bacchanal Radio.
Splash motion.
Splash.
And why did we have that song in our catalogue?
Mm.
Why did we have it in our catalogue?
Because splash and water.
There you go. So welcome back. As you know, the theme of the show is water and brackets, everything wet.
Mm-hmm.
Close brackets. So we had Splash there by Nessa Preppy and Patrice Roberts.
Yes.
And we've been bringing out all the best soca songs that say the word water or mention wetness or something of that nature. And then alongside all of our soca anthems, we have been, you know, chatting the things, talking
just
the things.
Chatting the things.
Just chatting.
We've been chatting a bit too much, but we're definitely chatting.
Oh, yeah, we were chatting a bit too much. So what on the radar for events in the next week? Share with the people, then they might want to come and see you.
Anything? Do I have anything planned?
Well, that's for your business. You don't have anything planned?
I don't think I have.
Well.
Besides accompanying you somewhere.
Well.
But I haven't got anything planned.
Shame. you do. I'll remind you. Well, I have, because I know, because we've got something on the same day.
Yeah.
So I've got the Barbados boat party next week, Saturday. So yeah, Barbados Independence is coming up. So normally end of November, early December is a lot of blue, yellow, blue things going on. So I'll be at that. I think it's, I want to say Victoria Embankment or Temple Embankment. Do you know what? Don't listen to me at all. Just go to Eventbrite and look it up for yourself and see if you can join me. It's always a really good night out on the Thames. A little bit chilly,
ooh, yes.
As it's an evening boat ride. But, you know, when the vibes is right and the right kind of music is playing, you actually sweat up the place. You see the windows and the mirrors, them sweat it up.
Steamy.
So I'll be looking forward to that. And while I am doing that on the Thames you will be somewhere else. And now I'm going to remind you. Do you remember where you are?
I do. But to be totally honest, I'm actually waiting for confirmation. So I'm like, I tap your things.
Oh, well, okay. So Marsha may or may not be somewhere. Marsha might be right next to me on that night. Yeah, you know.
Waiting for confirmation to come through. It's a booking. Waiting for to come through. Let's see. So watch this space, in other words.
The space is being watched. Other than that, we don't have anything else, I think, in the next couple of weeks. However,
November.
I do have some stuff. It's a bit further away. Okay, so I might as well mention, actually, while I'm here, in case people want to get their tickets or check it out. There's also the, I think it's BOFCA, B-O-C-F-A. I might be incorrect. And that is also another Barbados Independence Gala dinner and dance that is coming up. I want to say the, do you know what? Let me not guess.
No, don't guess. Check it out. Tell the people in the right things.
Let me not guess, because you know people then are going to be waiting on the wrong day.
Exactly. Share
and then be like, well, Ruth and Moore said it was this day and exactly. This, that, and the other. So let me open up. Here we go. Yes. So the 57th anniversary and dinner and dance. And is BOF, yeah, BOF, BOFCA.
What?
Lord of mercy. B-O-C-F-A. Barbados Overseas Community and Friends Association invited you to a gala dinner and dance.
Whoa, long title.
So it's the 2nd of December. It's a Saturday and it begins at 7 p.m. and it is in the Kensington Holiday Inn. So yeah, that's also happening pretty soon, next couple of weeks. So that's one I probably will also pass on to. Now, the day before, on the 1st of December, we have Pompasset. I love that word. Oh,
Pompasset.
God, the oldies will say Pompasset, but yeah, I haven't heard it in a long time.
Okay, so that's a kind of a Bayesian saying.
Yeah, it's like, it's not peacocking, but it's like, yeah, nothing, if you know what I'm trying to say. Yeah, Pompasset. So that is the 1st of December, and it is it's in Stockwell, so that's nice. Southwest London. Remember, I don't date any South London girls, apparently. But it is in Southwest London, 1st of December. I'm trying to see the time here. It begins at 9 o'clock and goes into the early hours of the morning. So that is the 1st of December, and that is Pompasset. Again, it's a Bayesian-ish event. I mean, it is put together by Bayesian people.
A Bayesian-ish event.
Well, I mean, the flyer is the blue and black.
It's pure Bayesian lineup. Bayesian DJ, Bayesian performers. It's everybody Bayesian going to be there.
I think it's like a mini independency kind of dance as well. So it says, join us. Oh, Lord, I'm going to say it's actually independent straight up. So it says, join us as we celebrate Barbados independence in style. There'll be live performances from Bayesian Soca Songstress, Miss Desire, Terra Dan, and much more. Look out for our special cocktails. Ooh, and ooh. Food will be on sale. Cocktails, special. Remember there's some blue cocktails, maybe.
Oh, I can't drink blue drinks. The colouring, I'm allergic.
It might not be artificial colouring, though.
I am allergic.
Okay.
So well, nothing with blue.
I'll have all the cocktails. They'll all be for me.
Yep, you be the drunkard for the day.
For the day? For the week. And then there also is another one on the 25th of November. It is the Barbados Independence Reggae Brunch London. So that's on the 25th of November, and it's at Fire Club in Vauxhall. Saturday the 25th, and that is from 12 in the afternoon. So it is a day-ish thing, so it's a brunch. DJ D Francis and Mr. Hooli will be there as, I don't know why I said it like that, will be there as well. So yeah, a very Bayesian heavy end of November, early December situation shit. But if you would like any of those, then head on to Eventbrite and get your business fixed. Mm-hmm. And I will see you there.
This rhythm. Ready for the job again. Hey. Can't stop, she call with a hit. She say I go hit. Mm-hmm. She asking me where I did. Say she coming, no, no, no. I did in a wet fetch.
drinking a little rum. She tell me don't make another rum. And before I start the fun, she want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, but she keep on telling me water and touch she belly water and she goes up water. Make sure I wait water for she to come. Water and touch she belly water and she goes up water. Make sure I wait water for she to come. She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, but she keep on telling me she rich, party bad. Yeah, say I never tell her. When I start to wet it up, she say she want she umbrella. She pack it up in a kind of way. Juve all the weather. Champ she in a corner bench, she like she pick up a dollar. She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, but she keep on telling me water and top she belly water and she goes up water. Make sure I wait water for she to come. Water and top she belly water and she goes up water. Make sure I wait water for she to. Not care about the watching, not care about the light. Anyhow, she turn on the pipe, wet it up like a light. Now go keep me waiting. Say waiting too long. She say anyhow she come. Ha, just make all the water run. She want me to wait for she to come.
She want me to wait for she to come.
Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, I doing it. Yeah, but she keep on telling me water and top she belly water and she goes up water. Make sure I wait water for she to come. Water and top she belly water and she goes up water. Make sure I wait water for she to. Ha.
Yo.
Yo, Mali, that one you slap with.
Wet it up, wet it up, wet it up. I'm gonna wet it up, wet it up, wet it up.
Back in our radio.
Give me them country gal, gal. Give me them tongue gal, gal. Give me them leeward gal, gal. Give me them foreign gal, gal. Let me wet it up, wet it up, wet it up, wet it. Give to the road cord. If she all about the money, with them for the waist, them the backers for the bumpsy. Respect the girls and them 007 charges. Enjoy it, do it wet. From you know you stress me. Wave something in the air for Carnival and Vinci. When she over, walk she up, let she feel the melody and wet it up, wet it up, wet it up, wet it up, wet it up. Give me them country gal, gal. Give me them tongue gal, gal. Give me them leeward gal, gal. Give me them foreign gal, gal. Let me wet it up, wet it up, wet it up, wet it up. Just like it's all I want when you see me in the band. Big up to Bungie gal, it's also known as Fireman. For this Vinci Soca, already know what he plan. They calling me Mr. Indy, also known as the Waterman. We jumping up in the burning sun like we want a suntan. Every man just grab a gal and every gal grab a man. Make me wet it up, wet it up, wet it, wet it, wet it up. Give me them country gal, give me them tongue gal, give me them leeward gal, give me them foreign gal. Make me wet it up, wet it up, wet it, wet it. Road code, code, code. Give you the road code. Road code. Give you the code.
Road code.
Road code.
Road code.
Road code.
Road code.
Wet it up.
Wet it
up. Wet it up.
Back
Bacchanal Radio.
Release the rhythm, say ho ho, hope you are ready for glow, the Wear White Christmas edition. It's time to bring out the Christmas outfits or wear white as we bring in the big fete before Christmas on Thursday, the 21st of December at Fire, Vauxhall, London, SW8, 1RT from 11 p.m. to 5 a.m.
I'm not coming to work.
Two rooms of music, 100% soca in the main room, old school soca with a touch of old school music in room two. There'll be giveaways on the night. Get your tickets from releasetherhythm.eventbrite.com. VIP and birthday packages are available. Email events@releasetherhythm.com for more details. Over 21s, no ID, no entry. Dress code, you must wear white or Christmas themed outfits. Glow, Thursday the 21st of December with Release the Rhythm.
Bacchanal Radio.
Bacchanal Radio. The Caribbean power, power, powerhouse.
Shake up your body in the water. Girl, come wine up in the water. Play some mess up in the water. Girl, come wine up in the water. We say shake up your body in the water. In the water, girl. In the water, girl. In the water, in the water, in the water, girl. In the water, girl. In the water, girl. In the water, in the water, in the water, girl.
Bend down and touch your toes. Drop down on the floor. Head, shoulder, knees and toes. Girl, I'm gonna bring the hose. Touch it down, take off your clothes.
Hey, girl, come wine up in the water. Play some mass up in the water. Girl, come wine up in the water. We say shake up your body in the water. Girl, come wine up in the water. Play some mass up in the water. Girl, come wine up in the water. Shake up your body in the water. In the water, girl. In the water, girl. In the water. In the water, girl. In the water, girl. In the water, girl. In the water. In the water. In the water, girl.
You're getting wet up tonight. After we sweat up tonight. Head, shoulder, knees and toes. Girl, I'm gonna bring the hose. Touch it down, take off your
clothes. And come wind up in the water.
Some mess up in the water, girl, come wine up in the water. We say shake up your body in the water, girl, come wine up in the water. Play some mess up in the water, girl, come wine up in the water. We say shake up your body in the water.
In the water, girl. In the water, girl.
Welcome back to Bacchanal Radio, the home of Caribbean vibes. This is the Bim Bam Show with your girl Ruth Amore.
And Marsha Miss Pond the Road.
Yes, and the theme of today's episode is water, open brackets, everything that's wet, close brackets. So now you know.
Everything that's wet.
Everything. And so we just played Slatter and Wet Her Down. And then before the ad breaks, we had Wet It Up by Zeeks. And Water by Skinny Banton. Wee.
A little roll there.
That was a good run of water tunes, for true. No, I like it. I like it. I like it. Marsh.
Yes, my darling.
Shall I ask the question?
Yeah.
It's been asked quite a bit, but we're going to do it proper. We're going to ask the question and give the answers to end all answers.
Okay.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
What is the sexiest? Now, that's different to the best, you know, depending. What is the sexiest Caribbean accent? And then we're going to follow up by what accent don't you like?
Oh, my God, the sexiest.
Look at me batting my eyelashes.
You know what? I'm going to honestly say, I think, that Lucian accent.
Oh, I was going to say Belgian. Anyway.
You ain't gonna like what I'm gonna say about the Bajan accent.
Oh, oh. Touche, touche. I like Saint Lucia mainly because, you know, I like French. I like that kind of like Creole. I like that.
Yeah, I like the French too. I don't know what they're saying, but it sounds good.
Ooh. What they be saying? What they be
saying? I don't know. I don't understand the French. I don't understand. But whatever it is, it's sounding good.
Mm.
Yeah. I think that is one of those.
But I do accents. Think of the Creole accents. I don't think St. Lucia has the best Creole accent.
Okay. Well, you'll say if Martinique?
I was going to say Guadeloupe.
Oh, you know what? I met a Guadeloupean man. Oh, yeah, he accent. Oh, yeah, I take that back. I retract. I forgot about Guadeloupe. Yes, I retract that one. Yes, I know.
So, if we're going to go there with the European accent influence, then I would say Guadeloupe.
Oh,
I would. I can
close my eyes and picture him right now.
I feel like I know who you're picturing. Oh, do I know the person? Sorry.
No.
Okay, because the people that I'm thinking about that have this accent, we both know. That's why we're talking about the same person.
Oh, yeah. Oh, his accent's nice as well, though.
Wait a minute. Who are we talking about now? How many men do we
have? The same person we're thinking about.
I don't know anymore. I don't think we're on the same page. I don't think we've got the same book open.
Is he a musician?
No.
Oh, no.
Who's the Guadalupian musician? Is it Guadalupian? Is that how you say it? Anyway, whatever.
Okay.
Who is it?
Okay, no.
What's the artist?
Who are you talking about?
No, you go first.
No, he's not a famous artist. He just plays music.
Okay, who is... Oh. No, I know who you're talking about. I know why you weren't saying the name.
You see, you do know.
No, why you're not saying the name. Is it...
I can't remember his name.
Wait. Let me just mouth it.
Oh, yeah.
Is that what you're talking about?
That was a loud whisper, though.
Duh.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. You're so foolish. Is he from Guadeloupe?
I'm sure he's well, he is now.
He is now. Honestly, this is so confusing. I'm on like an emotional merry-go-round. I don't know what is going on right now.
But where are we from? That little French accent he has there.
I laugh, it was just France.
Real nice.
Marta, this is emotional, you know. We started off at one place, then we went to another place. Yeah. And then I said, if you know who I'm talking about, we both look at each other and talk about the different... So that's the second person. Who was the other person you were talking about from Guadeloupe? Was it not him?
No, I know someone else.
Who was the other person?
You don't know him.
So why you can't say it?
No, because I know... You don't know him, but people out there might know him. And I'm talking people's things.
Is this accent? Is it more than accent? What happened?
No, nothing happened.
So what's the problem then?
No, it's all right. I just know he's from Guadeloupe. That's nice. That's all right.
If I'm from Guadeloupe, DM Marsha. Is that
no,
don't
DM.
No.
Don't do that. I just like your lot's accent, yeah?
You lot now, you know, it's getting very impersonal.
Yeah, very impersonal. I'm detaching myself from the situation.
It started off very different. I mean, okay.
Yeah, man. No.
Wow.
Accent's nice.
Wow.
It's a nice accent.
Marsha, you're honestly too much for me right today. It's just so confusing.
Very nice accent. Very nice.
So I said it and now you've just taken off. Okay, I can find somebody else now.
Yeah. No, we can share Guadeloupe accent. We're not sharing the man. We're just sharing the accent.
Oh, God. Marsha, I can't with you today.
We're just sharing the accent. Oh, God.
Breathe, Ruth. Breathe. Okay. Okay, let me just think of another sexy accent then from Caribbean.
Go on then.
Again, I actually like Haitian accents as well because of the twang. I like that as well. So it's along the same lines. I think Guadeloupe has got the edge on them.
Yeah, that's still kind of like the French influence, isn't it? Yeah, so we're saying all the kind of French
influenced islands.
Yeah, we're on par. So Dominica, St. Lucia, Martinique.
Yeah, but I just think Guadeloupe is still better out of all of them.
So we think Guadeloupe is better, but we will take any other lands.
This is not some... It's not some bargain bucket, you know.
Any of the other French-speaking islands.
It's like a get one free offer.
Yeah, basically.
If we can't have Guadeloupe, we'll take 2 cent lucians.
Yeah, exactly, basically.
So one Guadeloupe is worth 2 cent lucians. Yes. And how many is it, Dominica? How many is that worth? Seven? Sorry, what are we even talking about right now?
I know a couple of Dominicans.
I don't know any.
Don't you?
Not really, no.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, any other ones that are not French or Creole?
Okay, otherwise than that, then
I quite like Jamaican, to be honest, but not like country Jamaican. I quite like. Why are you looking at me like that for?
Even I don't understand what they're saying. The deep country,
like
them
deep country.
If I don't understand it being part Jamaican heritage, you have no chance. When they want to start,
I like it because I'd go normally to country when I'm in Jamaica. So
yeah,
I like that. Obviously, I think we should just exclude Barbados because I know you're going to start on them. They're going to see which kind of accent don't you like, which Caribbean accent don't you like. Sorry, so you made a remark about it already, so that's why I didn't even mention Barbados in the ones you like, because of course I like them. Do I find it sexy though is a different thing. Like, I love the Bajan accent. I don't know if I find it sexy. That's a different, do you know what I'm trying to say? That's a different thing altogether. So now we're going to the accents you don't like, and I feel like I'm about to get my feelings hurt. Sorry. What Caribbean accent don't you like, or do you find not sexy, like unattractive then?
Okay, love the people, love their music, but I just can't with the accent. I can't. And it is...
You haven't said the country. You're afraid.
It is Barbados. Are you afraid? I'm not frightened. I'm not frightened for talk. I'm not frightened.
You see, look, like it's up in one corner.
I'm not frightened. I just plan to be a little bit, you know, diplomatic and say it in a nice way and introduce the island. But it's Barbados.
So you caressed my cheek before you slap it. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
A little slap anticle.
Yeah. Soften it before I land.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's rude.
Sorry, guys. Sorry.
And there's me going to say, I don't think there's any Caribbean accent that I really don't find nice. Because I kind of like all the Caribbean accents. And then you with your fast self looked me in my face and said, take that plaps. Listen, the world is always
hard. It's just, that accent is hard, Ruth.
Why does hard mean unattractive?
Because it's hard. I don't understand what
because
you're saying.
You don't understand French neither.
But it sounds sexy.
So it's not about hard.
Okay, it sounds sexy, so I can compromise.
Oh, God. Maybe need... okay, I know what I'm going to do. I know what I'm going to do to fix this. Rather than me sitting here and getting my feelings hurt by your incorrect answer, mm-hmm. because it is factually incorrect, yeah, I'm going to fix this, and I'm going to win this for everybody repping 246 and everybody repping Barbados. I'm going to fix this.
How?
Because the next time we're out, because there's a lot of Bajan events coming up.
Mm-hmm. And I'm
so don't
with
talk
you.
Too hard before you're not even invited.
No, and I'm coming with you.
Before they leave you on the dock.
No, they're not leaving me nowhere. I'm coming. Yeah, continue.
If I manage to sneak her on to the Bajan events, I'll put her in a disguise with a little moustache on the sunglasses. I'll bring her on in disguise. I'm going to line up 3 Bajan men that I know have some soft-talking Bajan accent. Not that hard. Not that one.
See, even you know what I'm talking
no,
about.
No, because every country has the hard and the soft. Like you okay. said in Jamaica, like there's different.
Yeah, that's true.
So I'm not talking about the hara. I'm going to get 3 nice
How
Asian men. Hara. Like a pirate. I'm going to get 3 Asian men before Independence Stroke Republic Day to celebrate even Barbados Stroke Republic Day.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get 3 Caribbean men, 3 Bajan men to whisper a nice sentence in your ear, and you will not be able to tell me to my face that you didn't find that either attractive or soothing or nice.
Okay. Challenge accepted.
Yeah. I'm going to get 3. At least one can sweet
you. All right. Challenge accepted.
Yeah.
All right. Bring it.
I might even get one that's your type.
Bring it. Let me see then.
Bring him.
Yeah, bring him. Bring him.
Yeah, I'm about bring him.
Bring him. Bring
I might
him
even
come.
set the mood and everything.
Bring him come. Mm. Yeah, man. All right then. Challenge accepted.
Okay. Barbados, come on. Don't do me dirty. You got to. If I pick you, make sure you do it nice. Nice, yeah? Some nice, sweet something.
Yeah, nice, sweet things. Don't tell me to strip in this.
Don't, please, let's not talk about anything weird. Don't talk about, like...
Yeah, we'll go weird and funny. You know, some people just go a bit strange. You're like,
the wrong island, that's not us. Anyway, so yeah. Happy?
Happy, I'm waiting. Challenge accepted, I'm waiting.
Excitement!
people, man. I'm looking for house and land.
Who, me?
I don't watch people things. I's a queen. I have my own king. Or some of them, just talk like they go with all. Ask them how they get their Gucci bus. I go drink water and mind my business. Can't be English, that had to be French. Or some of them just talk the most, like they know it all. But if the ground water slip and I fall, it's them so all I go. Drink water and mind my business.
Mind my business.
Drink water and mind my business.
Mind my business.
I go. Drink water and mind my business.
Mind my business.
Drink water and mind my business. Me and you are no beef. I's the police and you is the thief. The people you think is your friend, them only they cause you have money to spend. Or some of them just talk the most, like they know it all. But when your head hot and can't see your way, who you just call? I go drink water and mind my business.
Mind my business.
Drink water and mind my business.
Mind my business.
I go drink water and mind my business.
Mind my business.
Drink water and mind my business.
Oh my God, are we back?
We are back. We got a bit sidetracked.
We got sidetracked.
Looking showing, at some Guadeloupe men.
Trying to remind her which the Guadeloupe people I was talking about was.
Fine. Fine.
But she's dead.
Fine. Fine. I'm fine. Look here, I'm fine no more. Fine. Papa Jesus.
That's what I thought you were talking about.
I would be so naughty with them.
Oh.
I would be. It's really bad.
I thought that's who you were talking about when I said
it. I forgot about them.
How?
I know. I forgot them from Guadeloupe. Oh my gosh.
Masha needs a moment.
I do. The vision that just came in front of my eyes. Oh.
Okay. So I don't think the answer is now like who has the sexiest answer accent. We're going to say, do you agree that Guadeloupe has the sexiest Caribbean accent? Are we saying yay or nay?
Yes.
Based off images alone, she decided the accent is the sexiest.
Based off them.
Based on how a particular person looks, Marsha's decided the accent is the sexiest.
It's not from one of them. It's not the same. It's three of them. Listen. Wait.
Oh my God. Ooh. Marsha.
I didn't bring my fan today. I'm hot, man. I'm hot. Listen. Foin.
It's a Guadeloupe has problems right now. Because Marsha's on it now.
I forgot about that. You see how I perk up?
I thought you were talking about them. No,
but you see how I perk up? You see how I excited now? Oi. Oh, gosh. Yes.
Oh God.
Anyway, I've got to take a pit stop down there, you know?
Get down there where?
Something to munch.
Marsha, can you hear what you're saying?
Yeah.
Then? You're taking a stop down there. And okay.
Down where these guys are.
Oh.
Your brain is worse than mine.
Like, what are you talking
about? Your brain is worse than mine.
When you said, I'm going to take a trip down there, I said, wait.
Anyway.
My cheeks are hurting me.
That's inside. We need to behave now.
Anyway, Marsha is taking a trip down there, so I'm going to drink water and mind my business, like Patrice said in the song, because...
I drink it water, but I ain't minding no business.
I don't know where the trip is that's down there and why you're going to be munching, but I'll just leave that to you.
It's going to be delicious.
Tasty, delicious. I think I'm looking good. Anyway. Honestly, Marsha, stop the foolishness. Stop it now. Stop.
Okay.
Yes.
What do you mean sink?
Welcome back to Bacchanal Radio. Yes. It is the Bim Bam Show. It's your girl Ruth Amore.
And Marsha Miss Pond the Road.
And we're already, listen, my cheeks are hurting me. I'm trying to bring them down, Nicole.
I know, my eyes are watering. My cheeks are hurting.
Marsha's so in much. A mood. She is a mood, even.
Yeah, we're in more of a mood when
Lord have mercy.
Anyway, let's reel it back in now.
Reel it in. You know, you've got to do the record thing. Let's just rewind that.
Yeah, okay. All
right.
We're back.
Right. The theme of this episode is water, open bracket, everything that is wet, close bracket. So if you've noticed, we'll be playing the finest, the baddest, the best soca tunes with the word water in it, or splash, or wetness, or soaking, or whatever the case is. Some we're playing it alongside our usual bants, dibbiness, dilemmas, relationships, even with a SH, and all kinds of things. So next up is going to be our little Caribbean chit chat. Mm-hmm. And I've got a bit of news and I want to share it to see how you guys, you know, how you, what you think about it. What are you thinking?
What's going on?
So I saw my timeline today on Instagram and that a very, you can call him famous, but well-known character in the Caribbean sector. You probably don't know him by his name, but his name is Daniel Lovelace. And he's the guy that did, you know, that goes on the streets of the Caribbean and he's like, I don't know, spell heartless or spell water.
Okay.
And because of the way people get nervous in front of the camera, they always get dibby and they can't spell it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or they'll be like, what's your national anthem for your island? And they don't know, the prime minister, they don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that guy. And he always kind of goes, now you know, or something like that. I think it's called What Do You Know? Or Now You Know, his little series. Well, not little, because it's a big deal. You know, he's quite popular, been doing it for a good amount of years
now.
Yeah,
he has. Yeah, yes.
Anyway, he is, I think he's from the island of Trinidad, and he has put in a song. I guess he's entering it into the kind of Trinidad carnival.
Oh, Soca Monarch. Maybe he's entering Soca Monarch.
It didn't say it, but the fact it's come out with the Trinidad songs, you know, the last couple weeks.
Trying to go for Road March or something.
I think he might be pitching it, because what, we're in November. It's pretty much November's out. So, yeah. It's, you know, it's given enough time to get airplay. So maybe he's going to go for a title. But anyway, he has released a song called Fettin' a Commissioner.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I was just like surprised.com. And, you know, it's been with mixed feelings. Some people are like, oh, they preferred him in, you know, the role he was doing before. Some people are like, they don't care. You know, it's a good song, whatever the case is. But I'm using that to kind of go and segue into my question, which is, kind of focused on people that do more than one thing well.
Okay.
So first of all, I'll ask you, can you think of anybody, whether it's in your like life, normal life, personal life, or a celebrity that is able to do more than one thing very well so that no one questioned like, you know, either one of their talents, basically?
Do you know what? I think there are, in normal life, yeah, there's many people that do things well, they've got more than one skill or more than one job, profession, role, or
They've
got a talent or a hobby that they also do well alongside their normal everyday things. Thinking of celebrities, you know, I'm not a big celebrity follower and watcher. I just can't think of a name. I know there is. I just can't think of a name right now.
Well, I listed some of the people that I know. The people that I like and admire, I guess, that I think have managed to cross over to something else and done it so equally well, you either forgot where they came from originally because they're just doing that new thing, or you respect them in both, like both their avenues. So I've got a few noted down. Let me know if you like them, if you appreciate them in all their different talents. So the first one is Will Smith. So he obviously started out as more of a rapper kind of, in that kind of era.
Yeah.
Then he went into actor, but TV, so small screen, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. And then he made it to like Hollywood. So he did like Independence Day. Trying to think of some other ones he did. Loads, basically. Men in Black?
Mm-hmm.
That was him as well, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Enemy of the State. Yeah, lots. Basically just lots and lots. So that's like three or four different things. Agreed that you think he's a...
Yep.
Quadruple, whatever you call it.
Yes, he's multi-talented. Latest talent is Jada Pinkett's punching bag.
No, I thought it was the doormat.
Doormat.
Oh, okay, cool.
I mean, dirty rag, anything. Cause...
Did you say dirty rag?
Yeah, dirty rag.
No, I felt bad to say doorstep because I actually love that man, but you said dirty rag.
Well...
Someone
if you believe what's going on,
I feel
on
bad
socials,
every summer
the way that she's dragging him.
I feel bad every summer. Someone comes with their nonsense on Twitter about, oh, it's August, Will's worst month of the year, and I'm just like, I don't even know how I got here. Please don't put me in this shenanigans. Let's move on. I'm talking about people's talents.
Yes.
Next person is Now, this person had me in a chokehold in my late teens, early 20s. Chokehold.
Okay.
LL Cool J. Oh, my God.
Oh, wow. Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Oh, even my sister's chokehold. Chokehold.
Yes. He actually, yeah, from rapping into acting on TV screens, and then he went into film as well.
What was the program again? It wasn't called In the House, was it? Something like that. I think it might have been called In the House.
He is in the house. He was in that, yeah.
Yeah. And then, of course, he was like Deep Blue Sea and a lot of... I forgot about the big screen because then now he does hosting. He hosts that Lip Sync, the American Lip Sync.
Oh, Lip Sync Challenge.
He hosts that, yeah. So that's actually four things as well that he's done very good at. And then now coming more into the Caribbean. So those are more international. I've got one more international, actually, or two more. Morgan Freeman. So he's mainly known for doing acting, but he also does a lot of voiceovers, you know, like all those.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. So things like, you know, like National Geographic, those kind of I know he did one for like penguin migration in the Antarctic, and like, because he's got that kind of soothing voice.
Yeah, that tone in his voice makes sense. Okay.
He does a lot of voiceovers for natural, like history, that kind of stuff. And he does reading of books. So he hasn't done Harry Potter, but he does those kind of things, audiobooks as well.
Nice.
And one other international is J-Lo. So a little bit of a change of speed, but she started out as a dancer.
Yes, actually. She did. Dancer. Yeah. And then singer.
Yes. And actress.
An actress.
She's been in a lot of films as well. So she has three kind of really solid talents. And I don't think she does anyone better than the other. I mean, she hardly ever does just dancing. I mean, she dances choreography and singing, but she's pretty much respected for all three of those things.
Yeah, I would say so.
Okay, so let's move into the Caribbean world. Of course, I'm starting off with Shao Marshall because he started off, well, I don't know if he started off, but he's more known for being a kind of radio host, DJ, and now artist, and actually still doing both.
Yep.
And same for Viking Ding Dong as well, because he's on the same show and he does those things as well. This one's a bit of a jokey one. Do you remember DJ Bravo? So he was a cricketer.
Bravo.
And then he did the champion. No, it was only one song, but the song was bad. So I had to give an honorary mention for DJ Bravo. And then the last one I have is Ding Dong, as in not Viking Ding Dong, Ding Dong from Jamaica.
Ding Dong Ravers.
Who started off, Ravers Clavers. And he was just mainly doing dancing with his troupe. And then he became an artist himself, and he is a good artist, as in, like, you know, he's released lots of songs, like very popular songs. And I actually often forget that he was the dancer because he has them in the background as Ding Dong Ravers Clavers, but it's not because he's Ding Dong, it's because he was literally in there in the first place. So, yeah, just a list of people that are really killing it in more than one sector. So, yeah, I think it is possible to cross over. You just got to do it well.
Yeah.
So good luck to Mr. Loveless, and I hope his song does well for him. And maybe this is the new him. Maybe he's not going to do the...
Yeah, you never know.
This is his new thing.
Open new doors.
Yeah, so you guys, when you're ready, go and check it out on YouTube and let us know what you think.
Nice.
And the bed, you feel bang it again. And if you take it as a do, you slam it again. Bubble, bubble, till long, and I show my head. Bubble, bubble, till long, be bam. Make your suck all night. Tell Superman you are the kryptonite. Just strip tonight, fit tech tonight. You arrive and the
and dive.
Underwater me, underwater me.
In a river, but me never go see no fish. Let me tell you something, girl, so young flourish. Come here for the karate, fi make your body nourish. Some a say a pleasure, some a them a say a punishment. Boy, you loco, that a chicken in a Spanish. You know chicken, it with us, I sit down and a labrish. Remember, say me tell you, say you're better than the average. If me tell you, supervise, can you manage? Make your suck all night. Tell Superman, you are the kryptonite. Your strip tonight, fit take tonight. You arrive and it. And dive underwater me. In a me pocket, make your suck all night. Tell Superman you are the kryptonite. Your strip tonight, fit take tonight. You arrive and it and dive.
Underwater me.
Bang it again. Undefended, you feel bang it again. Undefended, bang it again.
Pop it, long.
Make me swim, make me harder. Make me lose my breath, make me water.
I'll make you sweat, just play some soca. Make you lose your breath and you bend over. I know it's not normal. But you're whining too far, man. You ever been with an iron man? Broke off your box and you're home to your man. And I see higher than you. I from the water stay blue. Rum like red, rhythm and bass. Now you don't want to leave at you. Suck off me mango seed. Plenty vitamin C. I love it when they caress your lips. You don't need no legs. The night we under the sea. Scuba dive, I don't need no oxygen between your thighs. When I suck out your soul, it's demon time. I'm deep inside. Girl, you done flood out my place tonight. Yeah.
Make me swim, make me harder.
Yeah.
Make me lose my breath, make me harder.
I'll make you sad. Just play some soca, make you lose your breath and you bend over. If you need to hydrate this, call me guitar. I haven't been beach in a while, you must come catch that wave. Are you screaming shots? Cause I ain't pulling no. You want to open your mouth, you lay no bucking down. No, suck off me mango seed, plenty vitamin C. I love it when they caress your lips. You don't need no legs, the night we under the sea. Scuba dive, I don't need no oxygen between your thighs. When I suck out your soul, it's demon time. I'm deep inside, girl, you done flood out my place tonight. Yeah, I'm all.
Make me swim, make me harder.
Yeah.
Make me lose my breath, make me
harder. I'll make you sad, just play some soca. Make you lose your breath and you bend over.
Make me swim, make me harder.
Make you sad, just play some soca. Make you lose your breath and you bend over.
Bacchanal Radio.
What is up, guys? You are back. That was Adam O, which is the remix of the Tyler song, the Soca remix, Water. And then before that, we had Underwater. By Barb's Cartel, if you didn't know.
Yeah.
Dwayne me at Marsh were broken out our back. Broke it out.
And in the Water Challenge dance.
I was just saying, the Water Challenge dance to every other Caribbean woman is just the dance. There's no challenge word in there. It's just 1, 2, 3, 4, shake. 1, 2, 3, 4, shake. I don't know where the challenge is exactly. Some of us have it shaking before we even want it to shake.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know where the challenge is. But I was saying to Marsha, although I have heard the Soca remix of Adam O's Soca remix before, I haven't actually listened to the lyrics properly. And hello, where did all that? I thought Adamo was the good boy, the sweet boy of Soca.
Soapsy.
The man said, "Suck off the mango seed."
Hey, suck off the mango seed. You know,
have you seen how people eat mango? The...
Yeah, well,
is he serious right now? That looked like damage.
That one piece of sucking going.
That looked like damage.
No,
that don't look nice. Suck off the mango seed. So I'm like, there's no oxygen down. Listen. Let me not even repeat. I feel uncomfortable even saying the words. Yeah.
Hello. Very saucy. Not explicit, just full of innuendos.
But that one's double meaning. Listen.
That one's sweet. You like that one? You like that one, innit?
You are telling people things, you know.
You like that one? Suck off the mango seed.
Well, I'm not really that partial to mango.
You love it.
If it was a watermelon, then...
Watermelon? Will you give me that?
That's what I like.
Well,
okay.
Yeah, anyway.
Welcome back to bacchanalradio.com. Lord of mercy. We're spending a lot of kiki to the show.
This water show turned to something else altogether.
I know. As Marsha has said, the theme of this episode is water, open brackets, everything that's wet, close brackets. So we have played the best Soca songs from around the islands that have the theme of water or splashing or wetness or moistness or, I don't know, condensation. Who knows at this point? At this point, everything is going on. Oh, Lord, I have to catch my breath now. I've been laughing so hard.
That's hilarious.
Wait. Okay. Water shenanigans.
Yeah. Water shenanigans. The show's about water. So I thought, okay, what water shenanigans do we have? Can you swim? Do you drink water? Wet so fet? You know, like, what is it about
Let's
water?
Let's start with, okay, yes, I drink water.
Okay, good.
I don't know if I do the minding people's business bit. Sometimes I do both. Sometimes I do one at a time. Water, I do drink. Check. You happy with that answer?
Yep, happy.
Okay, wet fet, you know me. I'm a pretty fit girl. I know wet fit is not exactly a dirty fit per se, but it is a admin fit. There's still things that need to be done if you go to a wet fit. I prefer wet and foam fits or that kind of level than I do to paint and definitely not mud fits. That is not for me. I am not no animal. This is not Animal Farm. This is not Old MacDonald. There's no need for me to be rolling around.
Mud's good for your skin, you know. Double up, you know,
mineral, like proper mud from some sort of mineral fall or whatever. It's fair enough. You want me to be running down in that swill, that nonsense that we have under boot, all kinds of animal feces in there? No, sir, not for me. So yes, I do like. I don't mind a wet vet. Are you happy with the answer?
Yes.
Swimming, only like swimming at beaches. I don't like swimming in pools.
Okay.
Because all that chlorine and. I don't really trust people, so it's not really my thing.
Mm-hmm.
But I like, you know, sea, oceans, whatever you want to call it. I like that kind of thing. I like going to, like, baths, like mineral baths as well.
Oh, nice. But
them kind of things is nice. Yes, I think that's all the water questions, I think.
Mm.
You have any more water questions? You like diving? You like swimming?
I'm not a good swimmer. I can swim, but I'm not good.
I can swim. And I could probably save my life, but I can't save anybody else's.
Nah, like, me neither. We're both dying.
we're
both drowning.
I'm sorry. I have to say a prayer and move on.
Yeah, I'd say, look, just try paddle and save yourself, girl.
I would say, I will help you confess before you go and let you let go and tell you to walk into the light because...
Yeah, literally.
because I can't help you.
Yeah.
I cannot help you. I will tell your loved ones, you know, some nice things. But as for that, that's it, mate. I'm even having trouble saving myself, so
exactly.
Even that's not guaranteed at this point, so there's no way I can help you.
Yeah, nah. So I'm not the greatest swimmer, so diving, definitely not my thing.
Mm.
I like a wet fit. You know what I do like? You know when they have, like, those foam and wet fit, like on a beach setting, so you're already kind of wearing the correct attire,
and
it's hot, and there's water, and there's foam. It works.
The thing is, heat is a game changer in a lot of things. There's a lot of things I would do in the Caribbean I wouldn't really do here. As in, even when I go to beaches in England, I'm much more comfortable just sitting and holding everyone's stuff and getting the fish and chips. Like, I don't even bother. I will go in for like a picture or two.
What? beaches in here, the UK.
Yeah, I'm not even that bothered up here. But this is what I mean about heat changes things. Because when I'm on holiday, I'm all up in the water. Like, I don't just mean all in it like, oh, I'm up to my waist. I'm in it like head first. I'm diving. I'm looking at things. I even sometimes get like a snorkel. As long as I'm not going out till it's rough and stuff. Mm. But I even do the snorkeling bits and whatever. I even might try some paddleboarding soon, you know. I don't mind. Like, I proper get wet, but I don't know. You know, you behave differently on holiday than you do.
Yeah.
And heat also changes everything because, yeah.
Clean water also helps.
And when you know you don't have to drive 3 hours to go back home to your yard because you're all the way in Devon or Bournemouth or Brighton, wherever it is the water is. So, yeah. So then it depends when it comes to water as well. It depends. But I know a lot of people don't like it.
Mm.
They're not for it. And it is, to be fair, it's dangerous. Like, I've been on a few, like, speedboat things before, and it's been choppy coming back. Don't they take on, like, an island tour?
Yeah.
And then on the way back, it's a bit later on in the day, so it's choppy. I've been on some choppy things before where it was all fun and games, and everyone's laughing because you're jumping over these rocky waves, and it's all fun, and you're getting sprayed. But when you really deep it, like, that is not funny.
Yeah.
Is actually relatively dangerous. And yes, they have life jackets, but I don't think we was wearing them at the time.
Yeah,
so that means nothing.
When would you get to put them on if anything was to happen? And hold on, before we capsize,
capsize and start handing them out underwater as you're going
underwater.
It actually isn't funny at all. But you know, when you're on holiday, you just don't think you got any kind of, you're like a cat with nine lives. I have done. You should have seen me up Duns River. What am I doing there? But there's me climbing up Duns River like a real...
I didn't like Duns River, I'll be honest with you. I don't like...
What, the climbing bit or the beach bit?
The climbing bit.
Yeah, I don't know why I did it. The more I think about it, I'm like, why did I take myself? And you're in a swimsuit, so your knees are grazing
up. You know
up
how much I scrape up myself? Oh, God.
I saw people fall. And it's not funny to fall
it's
on the...
It's not fall.
Because... They just fell and stayed where they were. But if you were unlucky enough to fall and keep falling, you could be dead by the time you reach the bottom, you know, because them rocks, they look smooth. Them things is like, I don't know, greater. People were dropping left, right, and center. I don't even know. But then by that time you're halfway, what are you planning to do?
Got to continue. Can't go back now.
And then there's people with cameras taking pictures and all sorts, and you're slowly dying. You're fighting so much demons to get up to that thing. But yeah, like I said, you do things on holiday that don't make any kind of sense. Yeah. Jet skis, speedboats.
See, I like all them things on holiday.
This is what I'm saying. I haven't done jet ski before, but even worse, I sent my child on a jet ski because we don't you like do an island tour and they stop off somewhere and they're like, oh, do you want to do some water sports? And I was like, not for me. I'm too scared. Yet my son wanted to do it and I let him. And part of me now is thinking, was that even good parenting? He must have only been about 10, 11.
Did he enjoy it?
Yep. The more I think about it, it's even bad. I sent him on a jet ski with a person I've never met in my life. I'm in the middle of the ocean. He said, who wants a jet ski? I said, not me. He said, he wants to go. And he's like, don't worry, mum. We can pay when you get back. I said, cool. He jumped on. I didn't see my son for about 20 minutes. Gone. Off into the ocean. I waved him off. It's only about 10 minutes into it. I was at the ocean. I was like, "What? Where's my child?" And I was like, this man could have gone and held him for ransom. Like, when he came back, happy as Larry, in about 20 minutes, half an hour. So he had a blast. The man let him do... My heart was pounding by that time.
It worked out well in the end.
Yeah, but people be safe out there. The water, water is no joke, you know.
It isn't.
So actually be very safe out there. Don't do things to like, I don't know, show off with your friends and you know you can't swim and you're jumping off things. Don't do that because... No. Anyway.
Yeah, because the winter's coming up in the UK and you know sometimes the lakes and the ponds get frozen and you always hear every year that unfortunately someone has died because they want you to go on the lake or the pond. And obviously it's not frozen all the way through, is it? You don't know. So they go
in. Even if it's not frozen, people are going on these water tours and they're coming into issues and falling in the water. And because it's cold, you're even less likely to find your way out because you're cold. Yeah. So if you're trapped in the water, your time is ticking.
Very limited.
Even if you can swim and stay afloat, your time is still ticking because of the cold.
It's very limited. So
be careful, people. I don't know how this got serious, but be careful, people.
Be careful. Enjoy the water, but...
Be in the water, but don't let that water take you, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Jeez, take her, babe. Take her, whatever Iowa said, but that's it.
Yeah.
Just do that.
Who is it?
It's the plumber. I've come to fix the sink. What? Plumber, I've come to fix the sink.
I'm not your ex-man, I'm not the whole. corner man. I'm not no Mako man. No way, no way. I am the waterman. Professional done. Even on a holiday, hey. Cause when you get hot and thirsty, thirsty, and your lips them get dry and wanty, wanty. Baby girl, set your bucket just in case the pressure bust it. When me come lay pipe on the pipe, when me come lay pipe on the pipe, when me come lay pipe on the pipe, just set your water bucket, girl, lay pipe on the pipe, when me come lay pipe on the pipe, when me start lay pipe on, just set your water bucket, girl, check the water coming, check the meter fast, check the water coming, turn off the main stop car, check the water coming. I'm not the butcher man, I'm not no waste man, no way, no way. I am the waterman, professional done, to lay pipe in the hallway. So when you get hot and thirsty, thirsty, and your lips them get dry and wanty, wanty. Baby girl, set your bucket just in case the pressure was it. When me come lay pipe on paper, when me come lay pipe on paper, when me come lay pipe on paper, just set your water bucket, girl, lay pipe on paper, when me come lay pipe on paper, when me start lay pipe on, just set your water bucket, girl, check the water coming, check the meter fast, check the water coming, turn off the main stop car, check the water coming, check the meter fast, check the water coming.
Coming from for your blessings, the water blessings, I am blessed.
Now that is what you call a good feel good positive song.
Mm-hmm.
That's Sunday. That's a Sunday sermon song.
Sunday song. What a blessing.
Yes, by Iowa George. And then before that, we also played a lot of water songs. Obs. We had Lay Pipe
mm-hmm.
by Scorpion.
Scorpion, yeah.
Scorpion. And then Turn It Around by Square One. Lord have mercy.
Good tune,
you have
man.
To turn it around and then push it back in.
Yeah.
Turn it around and push it back in.
Turn it around and push it back in.
And then you turn around and push it back in. And then you.
Boy. The water running. The water's running.
Taps. Tap needs fixing. Pipes bust. Everything. Everything I gone.
Pipe bust.
This is very true.
Very true. Pressure bust pipe.
Pressure does bust pipe. How much pressure? Too much.
Mm-hmm.
So if you haven't already guessed, the theme of this season, or this episode rather, has been water, open brackets, wet, everything moist, everything damp.
Everything wet up. Wet it up.
Evaporation, condensation, steam, kettle, everything. So you've had a really, really moist show. Wet show?
They say wet. The moist one doesn't sound too good. It sounds a little...
Okay, we had a wet show. Yeah. None of it sounds right, to be honest. Okay. We had splashing good fun. We dived right in to the show. Yeah. We made a splash on radio. Yeah.
Splish splash.
Splish splash. I was taking a bath. Yeah. So we have had fun. Thank you for tuning into Bacchanal Radio, to the Bim Bam Show. It's been your girl, Ruth, and more.
And Marsha Miss Pond the Road.
Make sure you catch us everywhere on our two hot foot as well. Yes. And just to keep on reminding you, we'll be at Carry On Comedy 2024, May the 1st to May the 6th in Iron Napa. Catch us there. Hosting, supporting, and just being our usual Dibby selves. And it's going to be an event to remember. It's going to be epic. A combination of good vibes, not just Caribbean music, also R&B, all that. R&B, I think, also dancehall.
Dancehall.
Yes. And also, alongside that, there's lots of really good comedy events and showcases from a mixture of comedians that are, I guess, up and coming, and a few more household names, boat parties, beach parties, themed parties, and all to the backdrop of the Iron Napa sunset. It's going to be one for 2024 that mm-hmm. we're really looking forward to.
Looking forward to it.
Yes.
Indeed.
Make sure you go to Carry On Comedy on Instagram especially, but on all social channels, and check them out on their website. Get booking, as prices are nice and juicy, and you don't want them to get too high, you know, before Christmas.
And remember to reference Bim Bam.
Yes. So when you are booking online on Carry On Comedy, make sure you put Bim Bam in there in the promo code, and let them know we sent ya, obviously. And come on, join us to have a big whale of a time. That was a good one as well. Whale of a time for the show.
Yeah. I saw what you done there.
So we are going to love you and leave you. We hope you have a wonderful week ahead. Make sure you stay warm, whether that's with your central heating or whether you've got a nice snuggle buddy.
Oh.
Snuggle or snuggle buddies. I mean,
oh.
Oh, love. So yeah, be good, and we will see you on our various boat rides and parties and shenanigans. Thank you for listening, and we shall see you in 2 weeks' time.
See you later.
Hey, Choppy.
My girl, you're sweet like pineapple, you're sweet like tangerine. And I have the sweetest piece of wine here for you. Mm. The way that you're giving the vibes, I just want you next to me. And I hear watching you all night, I love off your energy. All night, your waist moving. I see you know what you're doing. All night, your body talking. You think speaking my language, you have my life, oh lotto. I'm feeling like I just spent the lotto. You have my life, oh lotto. You are the captain.
Sail away. Watch my hands on your waist and I'm trying to navigate. Sail away. Anchor down, let me dive in, girl, don't make me wait. Sail away. To the ends of the globe and right or wrong again. Sail away. Oh Lord, sink or float, I don't care what you're doing. Throw me overboard. I don't need no lifeguard, oh Lord. Rocking back and forth like a tidal wave. You are the captain, throw me overboard. I don't need no lifeguard, oh Lord. Rocking back and forth like a tidal wave. Watch me now. Me say one stroke, two stroke, three stroke. You're feeling sweet like the calypso. So me say one stroke, stroke. You're feeling sweet like the calypso. Myself where you come from, pushing you over here, no I want some. Keep checking just to see where you're leaving. I keep blinking my eyes, I don't believe it. Yeah. And if you got a man, don't bother. I'll make sure that you don't need another one. All night your waist moving, I see you know what you're doing. All night your body talking, it ain't speaking my language. You have my life, oh Lord. Oh. Like I just spent a lot of time. You are the captain. Sail away. Watch my hands on your waist and I'm trying to navigate. Sail away. Anchor down, let me dive in, girl, don't make me wait. Sail away. To the ends of the globe and right or wrong again. Sail away. Oh Lord, sink or float, I don't care what you're doing. Throw me overboard. I don't need no lifeguard, oh Lord. Rocking back and forth like a tidal wave. You are the captain, throw me overboard. I don't need no lifeguard, oh Lord. Rocking back and forth like a tidal wave. Watch me now. Me say one stroke, two stroke, three stroke. You're feeling sweet like the calypso. Me say one stroke, two stroke. You're feeling sweet like the calypso.
My girl, I feel like strawberry. My girl, I feel like orange. My girl, I feel like tangerine. Tangerine, tangerine. My girl, I feel like tangerine. And your sweet, sweet life. My girl, I feel like a little. My girl, I feel like a little. Oh.